Hi guys, welcome to this video. So I had a bit of a predicament last night, a huge storm where we live in the north of Scotland last night, and unfortunately the power is out on in the house today, so no electricity, so we've got no heating, no cooking in the house today, which is a bit of a pain. However, we're lucky enough to have our caravan, which has got batteries charged up, and we've got gas as well, so we will be able to keep ourselves warm and cook food. Now the only problem I've had is once I've come in the caravan is I've tried to turn the master switch on and nothing has happened. So if we look up in the control panel here, you can see our master switch here. Usually when we press that, everything lights up and we get all our controls up, and you can see when I press the button there is absolutely nothing happening there at all. So that is what's going to keep me busy today. Need to investigate that and see if it is hopefully something pretty simple that we can get the power on, at least in the caravan, so we'll be warm tonight and be able to cook some hot food. So let's have a look and see what the problem could possibly be. So the caravan we have is a Bailey Unicorn Barcelona. So the first port of call for me, because there's no power in the caravan whatsoever, is to have a check of the battery. Now the battery is in this little cupboard here, which hopefully should have left it unlocked. There we go. And that stores the battery. So what I'm going to do is to unclip the strap and we're going to take that battery out and have a look. Okay, so I'm just going to pull the battery out. Should slide out pretty easily. Now these batteries are very heavy, so just be careful. There are two handles on the top to help you, so we're just going to lift that out. And I'm just going to drop it down onto the ground. So with the battery out, what I'm going to do first is grab a multimeter and check, first of all, if the battery's fully charged. And then I'm also going to check the wires coming out of the battery just to make sure there's actual power coming out of the battery, and there's not problems with the terminals or anything like that. Okay, so what I have here is a multimeter. We can use the multimeter for lots of different things. In this case, we're just going to use it to test the voltage in the battery. So you can see in the multimeter there's lots of different settings. What I'm going to do is turn it to the left there to 20, so the you can see the voltage sign there. I'm going to put it to 20 volts, so the normal voltage out of a caravan leisure battery should be between 12 and 13 volts. So if we put it to 20 volts, that should show us that up clearly if there is power in the battery. So let's go and look at that. Okay, so with our multimeter switched on, we're now going to first of all test the battery. So I'm just going to go straight to the terminals on the battery. So your red cable that comes out of your multimeter, that goes on your positive terminal of your battery. Black cable goes to your negative. And hopefully you can see down there on the multimeter, it's reading 12.22 volts. So that's telling me that the battery has got a good charge in it. That's what I would roughly expect. So it's not a problem with the battery charge itself. So, next thing I want to do is make sure there's not any issues with the actual battery terminal. So these things themselves, just to make sure they've got a good connection with the battery, they're not corroded or dirty, so that's stopping any power getting through. So what I'm going to do is, there's a little bit of bare wire showing. You can see there's a little yellow cover that should go over that bare wire. So I've pulled that back in order to expose a little bit of bare wire, so that we can test if there is actual power coming through these terminals and heading inwards towards the caravan. So again, I'm just going to touch the multimeter terminal with the red bare wire and then the black with the black bare wire, and once again, if hopefully you can see down there on the multimeter, we're reading 12.23 volts, which again is exactly what we want. So that's telling me that there is power coming out of the battery through these wires and heading into the caravan. So even with power going into the caravan, it's not switching on at the master switch, so we now need to go and investigate inside. Okay, so now that we have determined that it's not a problem with the battery or the battery terminals, well, the next thing I'm going to do is check the circuit breakers and check the fuses. So down here in our caravan is a fuse box down here just as you come in the door underneath the sofa. You can see down here we've got some mains circuit breakers, and down the bottom row there we have a row of fuses. Now luckily there's a nice row of stickers there telling you exactly what each fuse, which circuit each fuse is for. So you can see here we've got lights 1, lights 2, auxiliary socket, pump, etc. But if we look down the row here, we can see this one down here, and this one here relates to the caravan battery. Okay, that's a 20 amp fuse. So the next port of call would be to check that fuse. If that fuse is blowing, then that could be the problem. So luckily these fuses are fairly easy to get out. You can just wiggle them out with your fingers usually, and we can take them out and have a look at that. Okay, so straight away I can see, so you can see just in front of my finger there's a little burn mark, and inside the fuse, it's quite difficult to see in here, but there is kind of a little piece of wire that stretches across the fuse there, which should be intact. It should be connected. That connects these two sort of terminals of the fuse together. This fuse has blown. So that to me is telling me that is probably the root of the problem. If that fuse is blown, then that breaks the circuit and no power will get through from the battery. So what I'm going to do now is go and have a look to see if I've got any spare fuses, and we'll come back and put a new one in. Okay, so here's the new fuse and the old fuse. You can quite clearly see the difference in the two. What we're really looking at is this little bit of wire that runs through the middle of the fuse, connecting the two fuse terminals together. You can see here on the left, the new fuse, that bit of wire is fully intact. On the right here, on the old fuse, which is blown, that has clearly burst, or that's blown. So it's quite obvious when you look at it, you can usually see that the fuse has blown. If you're unsure, just by looking at the fuse, then you can also use your multimeter as a continuity tester. So using the two terminals of your multimeter on the two terminals of the fuse, the continuity tester will give off an audible beep. So you can see if I touch the two terminals of my multimeter together, you should hear a beep. Okay, so what we're going to do is now do that on the fuse. So you can see on the old fuse, if we touch the two terminals, there's no beep. If we do it on the new fuse, there should be continuity. So you can hear the beeping sound. So that's another way that you can test whether the fuse has blown or not. So what we're going to do now is take the new fuse, and we're going to go and stick that in the caravan and see if that solves the problem. Okay, so we're just back down at the fuse box. I'm just going to stick that new fuse in. Just give it a little wiggle till it goes in. There we go. Make sure you push it in home until it's secure. And then what we'll do now is go back up to the master switch and see if that has solved the problem. Okay, so we're back up at the control panel now, and we can already see the clock has came back on. The master switch, you can see I'm turning it on and off, so that's worked okay. Down the bottom screen here, that's just our sort of controls for the hot water and the heating. Okay, so changing the fuse there, that has luckily solved our little problem today, so that wasn't too tricky a fix. So those would be my first two port of calls in these sorts of situations. First of all, check the battery, and then check your fuse. If it was anything beyond that, so if it wasn't a problem with the battery or the fuse, then to be honest, I would probably be calling in an expert. I wouldn't really know where to start after that. So I'm quite lucky that it was a fairly straightforward fix today. But also, if that fuse blows again in the very near future, we've got to then sort of investigate why that is happening. There's maybe a problem elsewhere causing that fuse to blow. So I'm going to keep an eye on that. If it happens again, then again, we'll probably need to
look at calling in an expert to find out exactly why that fuse keeps on blowing. But we'll give it a shot today and hopefully it'll be okay.
Okay guys, so thanks very much for watching this video. Hopefully if any similar problems occur in your caravan, you'll be able to diagnose the problems fairly quickly and get them fixed yourself without having to call anybody out. So make sure you click subscribe so you don't miss out on any of my future videos, and hopefully I will see you again in the next video.